Now, multiplication of decimal numbers, when you multiply decimal numbers, there are certain ways. First, let us take example. Reshma purchased 1.5 kg vegetable at a rate of 8.50 per kg. So, what you have to do is 8.5 into 1.5. So, there are two methods. First method is you can directly multiply and then you find out how many decimal points are there or how many numbers are after decimal points. So let us take a simple example, 0.1 into 0.1. 0.1 means 1 by 10. So this becomes 1 by 10 into 1 by 10. We know that numerator, numerator, denominator, denominator multiplication, this is 1 by 100. And 1 by 100 is what? How many zeros are there? 2. So just take one value, then again second value, so you have to put a 0 and then place a decimal. So after decimal, there should be two values because there are two zeros. There is another method. 0.1 into 0.1. What this becomes? 1 only. You just forget about these decimals. 1 into 1 is 1 and then put the decimal value because there are two values after decimal. So you have to place 1, then 0, 0.101. So this is 1 by 10 into 1 by 10 is nothing but you have this one area. You have divided into 10 places. Then again you have divided. This is 1 by 10. Then you are dividing the 1 by 10th one again 1 by 10th one. 1 by 10th of 1 by 10th is this part, single part. Okay. So this is how you get 1 by 10th of the 1 by 10th part. And I can take one more example. 0.2 into 0.3. 0.2 can be written as 2 by 10. 0.3 can be written as 3 by 10. This will be equal to 6 by 100. And because there are two zeros, one value here, one value here, then point. Then this is nothing but you know you can just have a look that what we are doing here is we are trying to take a fraction or fractional value of a fraction. So for that you have to have some decimal values. When you multiply two values, when you multiply the two values, when you count the number of digits starting from the rightmost digit and move towards left. So, we have to put the decimal points there. Where is this is shifting? Let us see. 1.2 into 2.5. So, this gives you what? The value is nothing but 300. 12 into 25. Just take 12 into 25. Then, there are two decimals. So, you have to take these 300. Take two decimals. One point here, one point here. These two values are there after decimal. Then, you put point here. So, this becomes 3. How about this? How about this? Exactly same. So let us take one more example, like you have to multiply 2.5 by 1.25. So you just multiply 25 by 125, you get certain value, say 3225. Now where to place the decimal? Because two values are after decimal and this is one value, so there are three values after decimal. So 1, 2, 3, here place the decimal. Okay, this is how you get. The sides of an equilateral triangle is 3.5 cm, find its perimeter. This is a triangle, the side of triangle is 3.5 and perimeter is, we have to find out the perimeter, so these equilateral has all sides equal. So 3.5 into 3 gives you the value, 3 into 3.5 just multiply 3 by 35, this gives you 105 and we have just one decimal, one value after decimal, you can place just 10.5. The length of the rectangle is 7.1 cm, breadth is 2.5 cm, area is length into breadth. So 7.1 into 2.5, you just multiply, you get in square units, 71 into 25 is 1775. Because there are two values after decimal, 1, 2. So you have to place a decimal here. When you multiply the decimal number is by say 10, 100 and 1000. So when you multiply 10, 100 or 1000, so the values, they are shifted. And shifted not on the previous discussion we had. Now we have to shift it on the other side. That is, this is 1.76 into 10. When you are multiplying by 10, this is nothing but 176 by 100. So when you multiply by 10, you have to place it decimal here. So when you multiply by 10, you have to shift the decimal on the right. When you multiply 2.35 by 10, you just shift the decimal here. 23.5 will be the answer. When you multiply by 1000, you have to shift 3, decimal 3 point. 1, 2 and 3. So this will be 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Okay. 0.5 into 1000. So This is 0.5. 0.5 is nothing but 0.5, 0, 0, 0. You can write any zeros. So, three zeros are there. So, you have to place it here, here, here. So, this becomes 500. So, whenever you are multiplying by 10, 100 or 1000 or any number of zeros, you have to just shift the decimal on the right. You have to just shift the decimal one for one zero at one point. Okay. So, when a decimal number is multiplied by 10, 100, 1000, the digit in the product are same in the decimal numbers, but the decimal point in the product is shifted on the right as many of places as there are zeros over one. So you can take one more example like 56.3 into 1000. So 56.3 you can write 56.3000, any zeros you can take. So when you multiply by 1000, this is 1130. So we have to shift 3. So this becomes 56300.